So we have an ASRock PSU here, PG1600G. This PSU is made by FSP, and like all high-end ASRock PSUs made by FSP, it has this special cable. 12-volt 2x6 cable. Look at that connector. This connector actually goes to a thermistor. A thermistor is attached on the other end of the cable, the end that goes into the GPU, and once it senses that temperature is high, it shuts down the PSU. Or at least this is what it's supposed to do. And we will test that right now. So what we did here, it turned on the PSU. As you can see, its fan is spinning. I have the cable, 12-volt 2x6 cable here. Here is the thermistor that goes into the PSU. Its information is sent back to the PSU. I attached a second thermistor and I wanna see at how high temperature it shuts down the PSU. And first of all, I hope that it will shut down the PSU. ...55, 65, 70, 80, still going on. 90, 100, 105. What the hell? A 110 degrees Celsius. Yeah, this is within the limits. As you can see, no damage occurred to the connector. How did I know that the PSU turned off? I heard the click from the bypass relay. This is a good trick. I know that, first of all, let's talk about some stuff. I read your comments and many of you say that, hey, Aris, this GPU doesn't have shunt resistors, so it cannot do load balancing and all this shit. Unfortunately, you believe, some of you believe that shunt resistors are there for load balancing. No, they are not there for load balancing. Shunt resistors are there to measure voltage drops. And through this measurement, you can tell how many amps pass through this circuit. Okay, so they are not there for load balancing, but the PWM controller on the card, on the graphics card, can take this information, takes this information, this power consumption information, and it can accordingly balance the VRMs. The input power that goes to the faces of the VRMs. Okay, that's the whole story there. So no, shunt resistors are not in a strict manner for load balancing. They are for way, way, way more stuff. I thought that we could make a cable with shunt resistors, monitor all six 12-volt gauges on the cable, have a dedicated circuit on the cable, so it will be far easier to check for any issues. When the circuit on the cable noticed above a very high amperage on a gauge, then immediately shut down the graphics card, put it on a standby mode by opening sense 0 and 1. When you open these two, the card goes to stand safe mode. It cannot draw any power. The problem is, with the transient load spikes, it will be very, very difficult. You will need to build an advanced circuit, and you don't have enough space here. Some cards will have issues there in general. They might have very high transient spikes, so they shut down. The best way to protect this cable is by attaching thermistors. This is a good way. The only problem here is that the thermistor, it's way lower. It isn't directly attached to any of the pins or the plastic chassis of the connector itself. My idea is to have more thermistors and even smaller ones, the smallest possible thermistor that we can get, and put them inside to get in touch with the pins directly. Or have the thermistors close as possible to the pins. By monitoring the temperature, it's way easier to implement a safety feature than by monitoring current. After all, what do you care about? The temperature. If the temperature goes very high and melts either the connector itself or the cable, this is what you care mostly. So, by using thermistors, this can be done. I showed you that this works. In this power supply, if it senses more than 110 degrees Celsius, it shuts down. To be frank, guys, to be completely frank with you, I haven't noticed this feature. Although I reviewed this PSU, okay, I saw the two extra connectors, I didn't notice them. I just noticed them with all the fuss going on with 12+4 connectors, and I thought, okay, let's give it a try. And it works. It's a very, very good thought by FSP. FSP did it first of all. This was my idea. I didn't know that FSP had already done that, but this was my idea. I thought about that 2 days ago. A different approach, okay, but yeah, FSP did it already and it works well. Our plan for the next days is to work hard. We found a 5090, try to check if indeed there is a problem there. And we're gonna test many different cables, many different configurations. I've already ordered DC milliohm measurements device, a high-end device, which will allow us to judge each cable's conductivity. That's all. Bye-bye.